Welcome to another Ranger Minute from Redwood National and State Parks. My name is Ranger Steve. I'm standing here at the lovely Klamath River Overlook, and today I'd like to help you respect leaves of three and stay itch-free. I am, of course, talking about poison oak. Poison oak, like its eastern counterpart, poison ivy, contains a volatile plant resin called urushiol. It can cause a severe allergic reaction in up to 85% of the human population. Now, the best way to avoid a negative encounter with this California native is to empower yourself with the knowledge of what it looks like and where it likes to grow. A vine in the shade, a shrub in the sun, with lobed leaves of three. Run, Ranger Steve, run! I'm really allergic to poison oak, but with the proper identification, I can avoid it at all costs. Now, you may be familiar with the phrase, leaves of three, let them be. Now, that's good advice, but here at Redwood, we have quite a few plants that have three leaves. There's Western Trillium, Columbia Windflower, Salmonberry, and California Blackberry, just to name a few. So along our overlooks, you'll often find blackberry and poison oak growing side by side. This is California blackberry. Notice the toothed leaf margins. This is poison oak, and I'm going to try not to get too close. What if you don't know if you've come in contact with poison oak? What do you do? Well, if that's the case, you'll want to wash your hands, the afflicted areas, with cold water and soap. If it's come onto your clothes, you're going to want to send them through the laundry too, especially your shoes. You want to make sure that everything's clean, because urushiol oil can last for months, and then you can get reinfected with it without even knowing it. So whether you're here to inhale the breathtaking scenery at the Klamath River Overlook or the Crescent Beach Overlook south of Crescent City, be forewarned, it's not the only place you'll find poison oak. Here in the oak woodland prairies of the Bald Hills, you will want to pay extra careful attention, because poison oak often resembles real oak. This is poison oak. This is Oregon white oak. I am now standing in filtered sunlight here at Jedediah Smith Redwood State Park. Here, instead of a low shrub, poison oak acts as a vine, climbing up redwoods in search of more light. Despite its infamous reputation, poison oak is a diverse and adaptable plant, and believe it or not, it plays an important role in the native ecosystem. It provides food and shelter for a variety of animals, including birds, elk, and deer. Not only that, it's one of the few plants here on the West Coast that provides us with beautiful reds during fall. Now, equipped with the knowledge of poison oak's tail, you can feel confident about hiking all of our trails. You heard it from Ranger Steve in the land of tall trees. Respect leaves of three and stay itch-free. This has been another Ranger Minute from Redwood National and State Parks. Happy trails!